This is Fame again, and we returned with another pre-vacuum video, three bedrooms.
So this home here that I'm cleaning has three bedrooms. Smaller room. Another smaller room. And a slightly larger master bedroom. Now I noticed that there was a lot of dog hair on the floor, so I proceeded to rake because I didn't know how to deal with a lot of the cleanup that I have to do with my machine. So this is everything I've dug up from the pre-raking. Really wish I could give you a good overview about how much pet hair that was embedded in the carpet just from raking it. You know, I use a granny rake recommended by Joel Wheeler from years back. And this wasn't the only room that had that issue. The other room had this problem. Along with the last room. So that's what I was dealing with today. And I'm sorry, I hope it's not gonna hurt with the content as far as like crunch or whatever, but I did not want to sit here and deal with the sight of just a messy vacuum cleaner and vacuum bag, you know, as when I break down at the end. So today we're using an SC899 and Sanitaire Mighty Mite. I don't know it's a correct number, but I know it's a Mighty Mite. They're on Amazon for about $100. Really good pickup, great for corners and such, which I'll be cleaning all the edges and corners off camera. As far as this vacuum goes, I posted it up before last September in the fall, and about a few weeks ago, I received 899 or 888 hoods from a great gentleman through Facebook, and it was perfect timing because I had a freak accident, and a whole iron fell onto the hood and miraculously dented it about right here. And so I had to swap out hoods. The original lampshade was fine, but I replaced it with a later version that I found on eBay. I also added a magnet to this machine right here. But as a whole, Vibro Groomer 2, and yeah, not a super fan or anything like that, just pretty much your basic run-of-mill Bissell run Sanitaire. And it does have a metal motor from the last series. I did install that. This is from the this is from 2010 when Electrolux took over. So that's what we're dealing with here today. That's what we'll be using. OEM everything else though, including the belts, spare belts, this and that. And this nifty machine, I've reused it already. Love it, I can carry it over my shoulder. And just a godsend. And this cool extendable retracting hose. This is really cool. All right, stay tuned. All right, now for the best part, the pre-vac. I wanna throw this in there that I just built. An SC886 from the ground up. Some fresh and brand new parts and just salvage parts, but it looks a good looking machine. And this place would have been a perfect opportunity, but I forgot to do my homework about the house, and I'm thinking the whole place is fully carpeted, and it's not, it's just a bedroom. So that'll just be an opportunity for next time. So without further delay, we're gonna do this with this machine. Forgot.
Thank you.
That's a wrap. I'll see if I have time. Hopefully get a bag dump in. If not, I'll see you guys next time. But this part's only for if I don't get the bag dump in. We shall see. Thanks for watching if you haven't. All right, so I'm in the middle of this bag dump right here. Let's see what we got. All right. Ooh. Once again, I appreciate you all watching this video. I'm sorry about the quality this time. I was kind of in a hurry. Next time, I hope I get to use my other machine in a smaller setting. If not, then we'll continue with the big machines. Until then, I'll see you all next time. Thanks for watching again.